Please follow me to Philippians 4, verses 6 through 7. Do not be anxious about anything, but in every situation, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your request to God. And the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. Amen. I'm so glad that you tuned in and that you clicked on this video. This message is for the person who is dealing with depression or anxiety. I started out with a scripture because I want you to know that in order for you to overcome anything and in order for you to overcome and conquer depression and anxiety and any mental health issue that you are having, you are going to have faith and you are going to have to believe in God. It is a must. There is things in this world that cannot heal us. Medicine can't heal you. Medicine can help treat symptoms or can bring you through certain situations. But when it comes to the battle in the mind and things that is troubling you in the mind, you're going to have to depend on the Lord. That's why I led you to Philippians 4, 6 and 7. So I am a living testimony. I suffer from depression throughout my lifetime and at different moments. But specifically, back in 2020, I went through a very terrible depression where I found myself crying and didn't know why I was crying. I found myself not being able to eat, not being able to drink, and not knowing why. And I was very grumpy. I was very silent. It would be up and down for me. But the last straw to my depression was me finding myself laying on the sofa for like 2 days, not being able to move. And the only thing that helped me was Jesus, was the Holy Spirit. I had the Holy Spirit speaking to me while I was going through these things, pushing me to get through my daily routine. I had 3 kids at that time and still had 3 kids. And I was working full time at that time. At that time, I wasn't really doing YouTube full time. I was just a full time social worker and I was doing some ministry work. And I recognized that something wasn't right. The Holy Spirit would have to tell me when to get up, would have to encourage me to take care of my hygiene, would have to encourage me to force myself to eat something, and would have to encourage me to cook and do things that I needed to do for the kids. Because I knew I was going through something, but I didn't know how I was going to get through it. And I took a leave. I went on a short-term leave from work for a month. And it's by God's grace that my job honored me taking that leave for a month. And I got short-term disability for a short period of time while I took care of my mental health. And in that process, in that time of that month, I was just talking a lot to God about the situation because I didn't know what was going on. I didn't know what was happening. So God sort of guided me through that experience and pretty much told me to look at the times when I felt most depressed. Because I would get like seasonal depression throughout the years, and I would always mostly get depressed around from like November into January. And I found myself getting depressed when I was running out of money, or when I was short on funds, or when I did not meet my personal expectations that I have for myself, and that will bring me down. And a lot of that had to do with me comparing myself to others, other people around me, other people on social media, And it would bring me down, literally. But this time, that depression really, really got me down, because I had, for 2019, I had made this list of goals of what I wanted to do, and I executed some of them, and some of them I didn't execute. So what caused me to go into this depression? So not only was it me not meeting my expectations that added to my depression, but it was me wanting to have the control and not allowing God to have control over the situation, or not allowing God to do what he needs to do. And I think that's why a lot of us get into depression, because we have these expectations that we put on ourselves, but God does not work in our time. God has his own timing system. And if he wants something to come to pass for you, or if he wants something to happen for you, it will happen. But you have to safe, you have to be still in the process, and you have to allow God to do what he needs to do. You cannot rush some things. Some good things and great things come through waiting. And after me taking a short-term leave from work that month, I actually went part-time too. Even after that month, I limited some of my hours, because I am a social worker. And I provide a lot of services to people, and sometimes, you know, taking on other people's issues, even though it was my job as a social worker, you know, it's my duty to help house people. It's my duty to help people to get connected to the resources that they need to make sure that they were okay. But I wasn't okay. And if I'm not okay, I couldn't help them. You can't help nobody when your mental well-being is not okay. So you have to try to, as much as possible, try not to have control over situations that you cannot control. And since then, I've been, God brought me out of that season of depression. And when I get to moments when I feel like I'm about to become depressed again, I reflect on what could possibly be causing me to feel this way or want to feel this way, and I instantly try to tackle that thing. Like, me not having enough money will cause me to get depressed. So when I get into those spaces or in those moments, I have to write out my bills, write out everything, write out, sort of monitor what I'm doing wrong that's causing me to not have as much income, and get that, you know, work on that, fix that, whether it may be cutting back on the restaurant food, whether it be me telling my kids we can't get these things right now in this season. That's what you have to do sometimes to get the finances in order, so you won't be sad, because nobody likes to be broke. I know I don't. It's not a good feeling. And if you want to stop having feelings like that, then you have to work on your finances and being a steward over your finances that God gives you. And you have to tackle, you have to reflect on Philippians 4, 6, and 7. Try not to be anxious. Try to make your petitions made unto God. Tell God the situation so he can bring you out of it, so he can help you to get through it, so the Holy Spirit can counsel you and walk with you, so you can be able to get through that. And if you are here right now, if you are experiencing depression, if you have a friend or a loved one that is experiencing depression, encourage them through the word of God. Introduce them to the book of Philippians and read that scripture to them, and be there for them, because depression is a very hard thing. It is very real. I am a Christian. I was a Christian when I experienced depression. We go through, we experience depression and anxiety too, but God gives us a way, gives his children away out of that situation. Amen. So my prayer for you is that you let God work. Trust in the Lord. Trust in God. I know that might sound cliche to some people. I know it might sound like a normal thing to you, but not to, you know, to do, but it's not always easy putting that into practice. But the more you start getting in the motion of leaning on God and depending on God, the more you will be at ease with all different type of situations in your life. I hope this video helped you. If it did, please like, please share this video, and drop me some comments below. I'm going to be doing more talking on my life experiences, things that God has brought me through as a Christian woman, mom, a woman that does ministry work, because I'm here to help you, and I'm just going to be including some of those experiences here on my channel. Don't forget to subscribe. I pray you be blessed, and always depend on the Lord. Have faith. Amen.